So basically, I'm the only female that's coming up here to talk to you. The only one with the vagina that will be talking about their sex life. So they're pretty much like, let's just get this shit over with right now. Basically, it's so weird to come up and talk to people about my sex life because it's super private, but at the same time, I'm kind of shameless, so it doesn't really matter. So I lost my virginity at 19 years of age, which is a little bit older, I guess. I had some friends that were 14. But it was one of these things where people thought I was a prude and that I wouldn't put out, but I just, no one wanted to fuck me. From like 14 till about 21. Then my tits came in and my skin cleared up a little bit and all of a sudden people noticed that I existed. It was a weird thing. But when you're 19 and you're finally having sex with someone, I wasn't very open about it and wasn't very honest about my status of virginity. So about halfway through my first time, so like 15 seconds in, he finally owned up and was like, listen, I've never done this before. And he took a second to process, and then he came and was like, that would have been good to know before. It was all kind of a steady downhill turn after that point. I had a few moments where I was in a relationship for 2.5 years, crumbled before my very eyes, but you know, shit happens. And then all of a sudden it was like, I just want to send my vagina on a rager. anything that moves, I don't even care who gives a shit. And I don't want to say name names because I'm kind of bitter. This one's about Pat Carter. But I dated this guy named Pat Carter for 2 weeks. And right when we started dating, he sent me a picture of his shit because he was really proud of it. And that should have been a red flag. I probably should have known at that point. But I kind of looked at it and was like, nothing can possibly go wrong here. This is fine. And guys, I want to be super clear about this. Whatever the size your dick is, it's totally cool. Just own it, but please be aware. And if you're not a Magnum, you don't need to use Magnum condoms. But Pat Carter, God bless his soul, firmly believed that he had an enormous dick. It was awful. So one time, I didn't have any condoms left. And it was like, you're covered, right? He puts it on, and we're going at it. And then all of a sudden, makes this weird noise, pulls out, and comes all over me. And I look up and was like, that shouldn't have happened. Pat just rolls over and goes to sleep, and he's like, you're okay, right? You can handle this. And I had this epiphany in the washroom where you're taking one hand and cleaning the cum off of your body, and the other hand to dig a condom out of your vagina. And that moment where it's like, this was a low point. I'll never be the same. You think you would learn from your mistakes, but I chose to keep making them because you're single, you can do what you want. What's interesting though is that it's such a taboo thing where if you're open about your sex life, people are gonna criticize you. Too much sex and you're a slut. If you're kind of not doing it, you're a prude, and it's like, I don't fucking know what to do anymore, guys. I'm not gonna win regardless. It's this weird thing that we criticize people on when it's such a personal choice in your life, so. Mind your own business, you assholes. You're watching us, want us to open up about this shit? God damn it. Criticize me all you want. Criticize me all you want. But there was a flurry of bad decisions, and just before I moved back home to Barrie, there was this guy named Colin Giles. Got you, buddy. He and I worked together for a while, and there was this goodbye party, and I was about to move. Why the fuck not, right? Go for it. And at the end of it, Colin just kind of looks at me and he's like, man, we had a bet for so long about which one of us would get to fuck you first. And now I can go tell all of the guys. And now I'm celibate.